In this video, you will see terminology check. According to European Cardiology Society guideline, the ECG criteria of focal atrial tachycardia. Now let's explain genesis of all criteria one by one. The arrhythmogenic mechanisms which are involved in atrial tachycardia formation are, or we call it warm-up period. All of above suggest re-entry mechanism, whereas positive P wave in those leads. This condition called aberrant ventricular conduction. This characteristic is a result of normal, rate-dependent slowing of conduction in the AV node. You can use the time codes for checking the most relevant information for you. Let's start from terminology check. Tachycardia means the heart rate that is greater than 100 beats per minute. According to European Cardiology Society guideline for the management of patients with supraventricular tachycardia, the term supraventricular tachycardia or SVT literally indicates tachycardia, atrial rates more than 100 beats per minute at rest, the mechanism of which involves tissue from the His bundle or above. Traditionally, SVT has been used to describe all kinds of tachycardias apart from ventricular tachycardias and atrial fibrillation. So the SVT includes different types of atrial tachycardias. Also, SVT includes AV junctional tachycardia that can be AV nodal reentrant tachycardia or non-reentrant junctional tachycardia. The group of rhythm disorder that can also be explained as SVT is atrioventricular reentrant tachycardia or AVRT. In its turn, atrial tachycardia is an arrhythmia with electrical impulses originating within the atria. This conception includes macro-reentrant atrial tachycardia, atrial flutter, focal atrial tachycardia, and atrial fibrillation. This video relates only to focal atrial tachycardia, that is one of the forms of atrial tachycardia. The focal atrial tachycardia is defined as an organized atrial rhythm, three or more consecutive atrial contractions, with a heart rate greater than or equal to 100 beats per minute, initiated from the discrete origin and spreading over the both atria in the centrifugal pattern. The ECG criteria of focal atrial tachycardia includes heart rate more than 100 beats per minute, distinct P wave with different than sinus morphology before every QRS, not changed QRS complex, QRS is less than 120 milliseconds due to not changed ventricular conduction except of cases with aberrant conduction. Different types of AV conduction disorder also can be present. Now look at this 24-hour monitoring ECG episode. Here we have only three leads. Paper speed is 50 mm per second. In the beginning, we see sinus P wave that indicates the sinus rhythm. On the top of the ECG, we see the heart rate and RR intervals in milliseconds. Also, in the sinus part, we see the negative and biphasic T wave. After this, we see the episode with high heart rate that is approximately 130 milliseconds. This is tachycardia, and the first criteria of focal AT is present. After this, let's check the P wave in this episode. For better view, I increase the voltage to 20 mm per millivolt. In V1, P wave in tachycardia episode is definitely different from P wave in the sinus part. The same changes you can see in other leads. After the tachycardia episode, we see the restoration of the sinus rhythm. So, the second criteria of focal atrial tachycardia is present. The next, we check the QRS complex. QRS duration in the sinus part is 100 milliseconds, and the same QRS duration is present during the tachycardia episode. Both of the QRS have the same morphology, so the third ECG criteria is present. Now we check AV conduction. For this, let's measure the PR interval. As you see that as atrial rate increases, the PR interval becomes longer. PR interval that is more than 200 milliseconds, called first degree AV block. AV conduction changes are not mandatory and specific criteria for focal AT, but for proper description, AV conduction should be evaluated. Now let's explain genesis of all criteria one by one. And the first criteria is heart rate, more than 100 beats per minute. Heart rate, or in other words, ventricular rate, in case of atrial tachycardia, depends on atrial rate and AV conduction. For evaluation of atrial rate, firstly we need to measure PP interval in seconds, and after this, 60 divide by PP interval in seconds, just like the heart rate calculation, but with PP interval instead of RR intervals. Usually in case of atrial tachycardia, atrial rate is between 100 and 200 beats per minute, as in our example. If you find atrial rate greater than 250 beats per minute, it is suggest atrial flutter, as in this example. So even atrial rate can help you to distinguish focal atrial tachycardia and atrial flutter. If you like the content, press like and subscribe buttons. We also have Telegram channel with ECG cases. The arrhythmogenic mechanisms which are involved in atrial tachycardia formation are follow. Approximately half of all cases of focal atrial tachycardia are caused by abnormal automaticity. The remainder cases are caused by reentry and triggered activity, especially delayed after depolarization. By the ECG evaluation, we can approximately predict the arrhythmogenic mechanism. Atrial tachycardia due to abnormal automaticity is not initiated by premature impulse early in cardiac cycle. The first complex of tachycardia occurs later in cardiac cycle, which is a general characteristic of an automatic mechanism. It occurs because spontaneous diastolic depolarization current in atrial pacemaker needs time for reaching the threshold and initiate an impulse. Also, automatic focal tachycardia is characterized by a progressive rate increasing at tachycardia onset, in other words, warm-up period, and progressive rate decreasing before tachycardia termination or cool-down period. Warm-up of an automatic tachycardia results from combination of sympathetic enhancement of pacemaker depolarization and gradual removal of effects of overdrive suppression by sinus node. If you need more information about the overdrive suppression and pacemaker action potential, we have another video about this. Warm-up is not specific for automatic tachycardia, but it can also occur with delayed after depolarization dependent triggered activity or some kinds of reentrant tachycardia. Often, prior to termination of automatic tachycardia, the rate gradually slows. Gradual slowing can also occur with triggered activity and reentry. Note that vagal maneuvers and adenosine may transiently slow automatic tachycardia, but does not terminate it. Atrial tachycardia caused by reentry has a paroxysmal nature, rapid onset, rapid termination. It is usually initiated by early premature atrial contraction. PP interval are equal to each other, and also some kinds of reentry tachycardias has a warm-up period. Atrial tachycardia caused by triggered activity is characterized by initiation by early premature atrial contraction and can have warm-up period too. Now let's go to examples. Heart rate is more than 100 beats per minute, which indicates the tachycardia. P wave in V1 has different morphology than sinus P wave before. QRS complex has the same morphology as the sinus QRS. So all criteria of focal atrial tachycardia are present. Now let's check the mechanism. First complex of tachycardia occurs later in cardiac cycle. At the beginning of tachycardia, the heart rate increases, or we call it warm-up period. The heart rate before the termination decreases, so this is cool-down period. Both of these indicates the automatic focal atrial tachycardia. Look at another example. We have episode of heart rate greater than 100 beats per minute, which indicates the tachycardia. P P-wave in V1 has different morphology than the sinus P-wave. Note that P-waves are merged with the previous T-wave in AVF and V5. The QRS complex has the same morphology as the sinus one. As a result, we have the focal atrial tachycardia. Let's check the possible mechanism. Tachycardia is initiated much earlier than in previous ECG example, which indicates the rapid onset. Termination is also rapid, without the cooldown period. Pause between the last tachycardia complex and first sinus complex is caused by overdrive suppression. RR intervals are relatively equal to each other. All of above suggests re-entry mechanism in this case of focal atrial tachycardia. The next criteria is P-wave morphology. This is the left atrium and right atrium. Impulse initiation in case of focal atrial tachycardia occurs in small circumscribed region of the atria, known as focus, and therefore these arrhythmias are called focal. P-wave morphology will depend on focus location, and it can be used to approximately localize it before electrophysiological study. A positive or biphasic, negative when positive P-wave in V1 indicates left atrium origin. A negative P-wave in first standard lead and AVL also suggests the left atrium origin. A negative or biphasic, in this case positive then negative P-wave in V1, indicates the right atrium origin. Negative P-wave in the inferior leads, the second, the third and AVF, suggests a caudal origin. Whereas positive P-wave in those leads favors superior location. If you wanna go deeper in P-wave morphology evaluation in case of focal atrial tachycardia, check the article in the description. The next criteria is QRS complex. Firstly, remind how the normal PQRST complex is formed. Impulse from the sinus node depolarizes the atria, then passes through the AV node and depolarizes the ventricle. In case of focal atrial tachycardia, atria are depolarized in another way. That explains the changed P-wave morphology. But from the AV node, depolarization goes as usual. That explains the not changed QRS complex. But sometimes, impulse from the atria comes so early that some of his bundle branches still has refractory period in this time. Usually, it is right bundle branch block due to its natural longer refractory period. As a result, right ventricle is depolarized after the left ventricle, just like in case of right bundle branch block. And QRS complex is wider and usually has right bundle branch block morphology. This condition called aberrant ventricular conduction. Aberrancy with the left bundle branch block morphology also can be present, but it's less common. Let's go to example. Sinus rhythm is present in the beginning. After this, we see the rapid increasing of heart rate up to 200 beats per minute. The first part of this tachycardia has a wide QRS complex, QRS is 140 milliseconds. The second part has narrow QRS complex, QRS is 80 milliseconds. Here the P-wave before every QRS complex is more clear that indicates the focal atrial tachycardia. Look at the scheme. During the very fast atrial rate in the beginning, right bundle branch was in refractory period. So we see the wide QRS complex that looks almost like right bundle branch block in V1. When the rate is slowed down, atrial impulse reaches the right bundle branch after the refractory period, and conduction through the ventricles is restored, aberrancy disappears and QRS becomes narrow. We have another videos about the right bundle branch block and aberrant conduction, link will be in description. The last criteria is AV conduction disorder during the focal atrial tachycardia. As the atrial rate increases, AV nodal conduction speed decreases, that lead to prolongation of PR interval and in some cases tachycardia dependent AV block. This characteristic is a result of normal, rate-dependent slowing of conduction in the AV node. It can be first-degree AV block, as we've seen ECG examples before. PR interval increases together with the atrial rate. It can also be second-degree AV block, type Mobitz 1. In V1, P wave is clearly defined. PR interval progressively increases from beat to beat until the drop of QRS. After the drop, PR interval is less than before the drop. But after this, we again see the QRS drop. Rapid QRS drop without progressive PR interval prolongation called second degree AV block type Mobitz 2. And the last ECG for today. At the beginning, we see the atrial tachycardia with the heart rate 130-140 beats per minute. After this, the heart rate slowed down to 80 beats per minute. We clearly see the P wave and measure the atrial rate that increases from 130 to 160 beats per minute. Some of impulses was not conducted to the ventricles. As a result, we have QRS dropping. Now let's estimate conduction by calculating the number of P waves and QRS. We see the second degree AV block with conduction 2 to 1, 3 to 1 and further 2 to 1. That explains the decrease in the heart rate by half. Have a good day. Here we go.